Hi, I'm Miley Oye, and I work at Google as a developer programs tech lead. In this video, our goal is to help provide information to site owners hoping to keep their site search engine friendly as they expand to new languages or country-based language variations. We'll begin by discussing some of the potential search issues that are more common with international sites. These are the scenarios that you'll hope to avoid during your global expansion. Next, we'll discuss background questions to share with your company before you expand your site to a new language. Third, we'll discuss two common use cases of international expansion. Given these two examples, we'll explain how your site's configuration can be more search-friendly using signals such as rel alternate hreflang. Rel alternate hreflang signals that this page has a relationship to an alternate language version at the specified URL. Finally, we'll wrap up with best practices. Let's begin with potential search issues. I like to highlight three potential issues that are more easily triggered as a webmaster expands their site to new languages or country-based language variations. In the first issue, imagine that a searcher is in England on google.co.uk performing a query for pretty items. The searcher might see search results highlighting pretty items, including a .com URL. This seems like a fine result. However, it becomes less relevant result if there exists an equivalent .co.uk URL that's tailored for the UK user. Therefore, the first potential issue is when search results omit a URL customized for the user's language when one existed. Another potential search issue is when search results display two nearly identical URLs from the same site, which may confuse users when only one URL was more relevant. The third issue is when a site owner expands their site to a new language or country-based language variation, and search engines omit the new language URL because they're completely unaware that new pages were created. These are the three potential search issues that we're hoping to prevent. Now that we understand some of the issues that searchers, search engines, and site owners face when working with international sites, let's discuss some of the important preparation questions before embarking on global expansion of your site. Hopefully, these questions will help set expectations for your business or within your company. 1. Is your entire company committed to developing an experience tailored to users of a different language or country-based language variation? Global expansion doesn't mean just translate content and publish new pages. It's also about creating a great experience for your new users, an experience tailored to their language, market, and culture. 2nd question, is your team committed to not just creating, but also reviewing and maintaining content for the different users worldwide? It's important to emphasize to your coworkers that content creation alone isn't sufficient to build a solid international site. Your team will also need to review the content to make sure it's in the local user's language, and maintain the content over time so it remains up to date. Last, is your team committed to supporting customers, often post-sale, in a new country or language? Even after you make a sale or conversion, customers may want to email or call for support. Your company may need to support personnel that speaks the new customer's language, understands their concerns, and is available during their time zone. I mention this because one of the most common questions I receive is something similar to, we're the number one ranking site in our country. Why aren't we ranking as high in our new target countries? It's helpful to set proper expectations within your company. Global expansion can require more dedication. Now let's cover the two main use cases for international sites. The first use case is when a site has a regional variation of a single language. In this use case, on www.example.com, the page is in American English using US dollars. However, the site may have a UK version of the page available at en-gb.example.com. On this UK version, the page uses British English and the currency is in pounds rather than dollars. Again, this is the use case of country-based language variations of the same language. The second use case is when a website expands internationally with full translations of content. So the word car on one page is coche on another page and auto on yet another page. In this image, www.example.com is written in English, while es.example.com is written entirely in Spanish. These pages are fully translated so that my homepage becomes mi página de inicio. Hopefully, one or several of these use cases will apply to the configuration on or proposed for your site. Given these use cases, how can your international site be more search-friendly? I'll explain. In December 2011, we introduced support for rel alternate hreflang as a way for webmasters to specify to search engines like Google how their global site is configured. By using rel alternate hreflang, you can signal to Google how you've expanded your website to new languages or country-based language variations. Rel alternate hreflang is a signal, not a directive. And because it's one of the many signals used to serve users the most relevant results, it's possible that other inputs override the rel alternate hreflang specification. Rel alternate hreflang can be listed in several places. Select only one option, whichever is easiest for you. It can be placed in on-page markup as a link attribute in the head of your document. Rel alternate hreflang can also be included in the page's link HTTP header. Another convenient way to specify rel alternate hreflang is in a sitemap. The sitemap will list all language or country-based language alternates for each URL. If your international expansion spans across several sites, you can submit just one sitemap listing all alternates for each URL, as long as each of the websites is verified in Google Webmaster Tools. Whether you specify rel alternate hreflang in on-page markup, HTTP headers, or a sitemap, you'll include an hreflang value. This value can be a general language like EN for English for all the English users worldwide. Additionally, you can include both language and country, such as ENGB, to better target English speakers in the UK. If you choose to create a country-based language variation, such as ENGB, we recommend also having a general language version, like EN, to appeal to English speakers worldwide. What will happen in search results if you don't specify a general language, such as EN, and only include ENGB and ENUS? What do English-speaking users outside of those regions, say in Canada or Australia, see in their search results? Or what happens if you choose not to specify rel alternate hreflang at all? Well, in all of these cases, we'll still do our best to find the most relevant version of the page for the searcher, similar to our behavior before supporting rel alternate hreflang in 2011. If you have a URL that doesn't consistently serve content in one language, perhaps it redirects to different language pages based on the user's IP, or it dynamically serves different language content on the same page, or it's a page which only asks the user to select their preferred homepage, then your hreflang value can be xDefault. xDefault signals to search engines that the URL's language is broad rather than specific. An example where hreflang xDefault could be useful is in the Google Play Store. The Google Play page dynamically serves content in different languages on the same URL. The href values for rel alternate hreflang should specify canonical URLs. And in fact, to be most efficient, they only need to be included on the canonical URL, not the duplicates. In other words, given the English version of a page, http://example.com/en/page?item=1 and SID=123, which is a duplicate URL with a session ID, there doesn't need to contain hreflang values to the corresponding, say, German page. It only needs to specify the rel canonical URL, for example, example.com/en/page?item=1. Then, on this canonical URL, include rel alternate hreflang to the canonical German equivalent page, example.com/de/page?item=1. If this sounds too complicated, just remember to include only canonical URLs whenever specifying rel alternate hreflang, and you should be fine. When you implement rel alternate hreflang, all alternates of the URL, including the URL itself, should be declared, whether that's with on-page markup, sitemaps, or HTTP headers. The alternate language versions can be on the same or different domains. They can be on different subdirectories, subdomains, ccTLDs, or gTLDs. If you have the option, however, we recommend keeping the alternate versions in a similar URL structure, as that will aid our crawling and indexing heuristics. When using rel alternate hreflang, you can still use Webmaster Tools' geographic target feature for your verified subdomains or subdirectories that you'd like to target to a particular country. With the geographic target setting, be aware that you can only target a verified site to one country. So if you want to target users from two different regions, but you only have a general language page, geo-targeting in Webmaster Tools won't be possible. For instance, if you want to target Portuguese users in Portugal and Portuguese users in Brazil, but you only have a general PT language page, you won't want to configure geographic target in Webmaster Tools. With only a general PT Portuguese version, rather than PTPT and PTBR, you'll limit your audience to only one of your two desired locations. Another important detail about rel alternate hreflang is that while it's supported by Google, it may not be treated by other major search engines in the same manner. Now let's return to our use cases and how the rel alternate hreflang configuration can look on your site. In the case of country-based variations of the same language, both of the corresponding URLs are listed for each page. Again, all variations are specified on each page, not just the alternates excluding the current page. We require listing all alternates because it demonstrates a more bona fide association. It's much harder for an outsider to try and join as a different language version of your site. For the use case of full translations, such as www for English and es for Spanish, again, each page will contain all alternates, including itself. For the use case of full translations with country-based language variations, it's just as you would expect. Each page lists all alternates, including itself. Now that you understand the configuration of rel alternate hreflang, let's review the benefits. One benefit is that when implemented correctly, rel alternate hreflang helps search engines like Google to understand the relationship between the pages on your site so we can more accurately crawl and index your pages. Another benefit of using this markup is that it helps search engines to discover new URLs as you expand your site. For instance, one page may have four alternates listed. If we're only aware of three alternates, then we'll schedule the fourth URL to be crawled. Once the page is crawled, it can then be indexed and available in search results. The last benefit I'd like to cover is that by using the signal of rel alternate hreflang, we can serve searchers a more targeted URL in their results. By doing so, users are often given a more tailored experience on your site. The final portion of this video deals with best practices when expanding your site. The first best practice is to strive to create shareable URLs in your site architecture. This means that each URL consistently serves similar information in the same language, regardless of the user's IP or language preference. This greatly assists indexing by search engines, and by creating shareable URLs, if a user bookmarks your page or promotes your site on their blog, their audience, whether in the US or in Germany, will see the content that they intended. When it comes to auto-redirecting users, while that can be done from an X-default URL to a language or country-specific URL, we discourage auto-redirecting, say, based on IP, from one language URL to a different language URL. This implementation could prevent all language versions from being crawled. If you'd like to suggest a more targeted page to users, based on their IP or language preference, a common implementation is to display a banner suggesting an alternate page. Another best practice is to avoid placing language or country in a URL parameter. This is because URL parameters are less consistent in behavior than domains or directories. URL parameters are often overloaded. The parameter may have started as a placeholder for language. The parameter later incorporated tracking or session IDs. When expanding your site to include additional languages, it's more search-friendly to use different ccTLDs, domains, subdirectories, or subdomains. This isn't a requirement, But by keeping a more consistent URL structure between languages, you help our heuristics to more efficiently crawl and index your site. In URLs, UTF-8 is our recommendation for non-ASCII characters in the URL path, file name, or parameters. From a business development standpoint, look to develop customers, fans, advocates, and gain a following from users in your new language. I state this as a best practice because I'm commonly asked, should I put effort in getting links in the language or country where my site is expanding? The higher level answer is that you'll want to do the same beneficial, above the board business practices in your new language as you executed in your original language. In general, building excitement about your site, such as referrals and reviews from happy existing customers, helps build awareness to new potential customers. Another best practice is paying attention to page speed, especially if your new language pages are serving users from a greater network distance. For example, if your servers are located in Australia, but you hope to serve English users in the United States, check that your American users aren't experiencing unwanted delays. Speaking of users in different locations, strive to empower the individual user to find their preferred language. Users often appreciate the ability to switch a page to their language of choice rather than be locked in to the language of their IP. The last best practice is referencing available resources. We have several articles that may be of help. Working with multilingual sites, multiregional sites, rel alternate hreflang, rel alternate hreflang ex default. And of course, you can also read questions from fellow webmasters expanding their site, or even post your own question, in the internationalization section of the Webmaster Discussion Forum. Thanks for your time and effort in expanding your site to be search engine friendly. We wish you the best of luck as you embark on new languages or country-based language variations. Thanks for watching.